A quick reminder to get things started, there's still time to fill out the annual Army Housing Tenant Satisfaction Survey. It's open through February 24th. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also on this edition, we welcome a former Garrison Commander back in a new role. Kimbrough offers mobile prescription activation and some tax assistance news. These stories and more, but first, good news from this week's installation town hall. Fort Meade Garrison Commander Colonel Chris Nyland announced that effective February 14th, the installation would change from Health Protection Condition Bravo Plus to HPCON Bravo.
Building occupancy levels will be able to increase from 40% to 50%. We are going to reauthorize non-mission essential gatherings in community spaces. We're going to open indoor dining at the AFES and DFMWR facilities. We're going to reopen the showers at the gyms and the RV park. We're going to restart the youth sports program. And you'll see the bowling center will be reopened, and counter-based customer service at Pet Care Center, Arts and Crafts, and Leisure Travel Services will all reopen. Local organizations and agencies may have higher standards inside their specific facilities due to the nature of their, either due to the nature of their mission or simply the ergonomics of their facilities.
There's much more from the town hall on these changes. Just go to our Facebook page and click on videos. In other news, the Tax Assistance Center at Joint Base Meyer-Henderson Hall is now open. They're serving service members and retirees in the National Capital Region. Here's a portion of a video detailing those services.
I'm Master Sergeant Matt Heil. Welcome to the Joint Base Meyer-Henderson Hall Consolidated Tax Center for the 2021 tax filing season. We offer free, professional, and accurate assistance to active duty military personnel, retirees, and their dependents.
I'm Staff Sergeant Sergey Prokofiev. This year, we're preparing your taxes virtually by appointment only. Customers can begin scheduling appointments on February 7th, 2022. Please email the Tax Center at usarmy.jbmhh.md.mbx.legal-taxcenter@army.mil.
The entire video includes important tax law changes and who's eligible for assistance. It's available at www.facebook.com/Meyer Tax Center. Here's a quick note from Kimbrough Ambulatory Care Center. Mobile prescription activation is now available. You can request new or renewed prescriptions using your mobile device. Just text Get in Line to 833-224-5456. You'll receive a text notifying you that your prescription is ready for pickup. One reminder though, this service is not for making refill requests. It's only for new or renewed prescriptions. Elsewhere, in August 2016, then Garrison Commander Colonel Brian Foley relinquished command in ceremonies on the Fort Meade Parade Field. Fast forward about 5 years in assignments at the Pentagon and at DISA, Colonel Foley returned to Fort Meade a month ago as the Deputy Garrison Commander, the senior civilian in the garrison. In this interview excerpt, Mr. Foley talks about his top priority.
First and foremost, get our onboard strength of Department of the Army civilians up as high as possible. As close to 100% of our total authorized personnel as we possibly can be, starting with key vacancies in some key directorate and key leadership positions here in the installation that have been vacant for many years for various reasons and through turnover.
You can read more on Mr. Foley's priorities and catch up with what he's been doing since he left Fort Meade. That story will be available on our website's digital media page. Meanwhile, in news from Anne Arundel County Public Schools, Meade High student Lauren Wilson is one of four recipients of the first MOGABA Perseverance Awards. If you're a Baltimore sports fan, you're probably familiar with MOGABA, the Baltimore Orioles and Ravens superfan, was famous as a sports radio personality and was the first person to announce an NFL draft pick in Braille. He battled cancer his entire life before succumbing at 14 years old. The award named in his honor recognizes students for their positive attitude, kindness, and ability to overcome challenges. The winner school receives a banner and a $500 prize for school projects to promote kindness and positive attitudes. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.